The Philippine Scout Rangers are a cut above the rest. A light, quick reaction force, trained to strike hard and fast, deep behind enemy lines. But to join this elite crew, soldiers must first endure 6 months of hell. To earn the coveted combat tag, it's a brutal selection course. Most will fail. To graduate, they must face a test of life. A live combat mission against insurgents, where some will pay the ultimate sacrifice. The Philippine Scout Rangers are fearsome anti-guerrilla fighters.
We evaluate our targets, we analyze, we discuss who among them needs elimination.
They are trained to operate in dense jungle terrain found across the Philippines archipelago.
The Scout Rangers go behind deep enemy lines with just small teams, little as 7 men.
Traveling light and hitting hard. And to be able to strike fast, they use helicopters to hit the battle zone, specializing in raids, ambushes, and sabotage. The Philippines has long been plagued by domestic conflicts, one of which gave birth to this elite unit.
The first Scout Ranger Regiment was formed in 1950 because the government is looking for a solution to counter the guerrilla tactics of our then communist armed groups. They're called the Hooks.
Skilled in unconventional jungle warfare, the unit was modeled after two legendary fighting groups, the intelligence-gathering American Alamo Scouts and the combat-ready U.S. Army Rangers. 112 students joined the first Scout Ranger class. Only 72 graduated. But to become a member of this elite group, soldiers must first pass 6 months of advanced training. And it all starts here, at Camp Texon, San Miguel, Bulacan, in the northern Philippines. These 206 volunteers are already trained soldiers from other Army regiments.
Rangers, good morning.
Vying to become part of an even more elite military club. First, they will be stripped of all their ranks. Here, every man is equal. All aiming for one thing. The coveted tabak tag of the Scout Ranger Training School.
The red border signifies the blood, sweat, and tears shed by every ranger during his course. The sword symbolizes our special unit capability, and the words we strike symbolizes our capability to go anywhere, any place, and any time.
Today is known as Reception Day, and recruits are in for a grueling welcome. For the next 5 hours, these instructors will try and break as many as possible through continuous physical exercises. It's not just the instructors who will be brutal. Today is a searing 32 degrees Celsius. Just 10 minutes in, and the course has already claimed its first victim to the heat. But he's not alone. Four more recruits have reached their limits. Recruit 54 has collapsed from heat exhaustion. He's being taken to the medical area to get his body temperature down. For others, hell has just begun.
Mission unspoken.
The second run sees more recruits drop. Medics are called in for even more severe cases of heat exhaustion. The exercise has depleted their bodies of essential water and salts. It results in dizziness, vomiting, loss of consciousness, and control. If not treated fast enough, it can develop into heat stroke, a potentially fatal condition.
If the condition is already heat stroke, the regulatory mechanisms of the body has already malfunctioned.
Ibuksan mo 'to ano niya kasi kinagat niya 'yung dila niya. Pagkatin mo.
Ranger.
Ranger, pagkatin. Buksan mo.
Then the patient started to bleed. That would result to multiple organ failure.
Recruits are only allowed up to 72 hours of medical grace from the entire course. If they use up all these hours, they will fail. It's only been 1 hour since they signed up, and already, some are so ill they won't recover in time. Only the strongest will survive.
Sa schooling kasi ito, briefing na kasi ako sa mga senior ko na nauna pa sa akin na mag-schooling nito. Kung gusto mo talagang makuha ang isang bagay, pagbutihin mo yung kuan talaga na yung galing sa puso mo ba na...
The next challenge sees them hitting the ground. The unfit or unwilling have no place in the Scout Rangers.
Bilisan! Bilisan! Bilisan!
At age 32, Recruit 1 is one of the oldest in the course.
This is my ambition. It is very difficult and it's very hard to be trained as a ranger. That's why I don't know what's the training I will going to survive this kind of course.
Hours to go. For those still in the game, the pain is nearly over. Reception has nearly ended. But this last tradition is a hard one to stomach. Chili's.
Right now, this is the final phase of our reception rites. We're trying to let them eat the chili pepper. And the juice of it. So after this, they're licking the tabak sign or insignia. And then the Musang or the Black Panther, it's our logo for the Scout Rangers.
Finally, reception day is over. But disappointment sets in as these recruits realize their Scout Ranger dream is over.
Hindi ko na nalaman kung saan ako nag-give up yung katawan ko. Basta nagising na lang ako na parang nahilo na hindi na nakayanan ng katawan ko.
At the end of day one, the damage is clear. 35 have quit. 171 remain standing. And this is just the beginning. Philippine Scout Ranger recruits are 7 weeks into their brutal training regime. 53 have already dropped out.
Those who fail to graduate has one thing in common. They easily give up. The battle has been won yet, they already doubt themselves. Once you doubt yourself, the affinity will not finish the course.
Pag exit sa static line, sisigaw ng opera pin. Nakuha.
Yes, sir.
The recruits will test their heads for heights today. They're going to learn to rappel on this 45-foot tower.
Ranger Brother, request permission to enter the tower at the back. Sergeant!
Scout Rangers pride themselves in lightning infiltration and extraction, often from helicopters, into dense jungles.
Rangers specialize in jungle warfare. They rappel down mountains, cross rivers, using expedite methods or anything that's available within them.
In the jungle, they need to feel comfortable hanging at 100 feet in the air, well under fire. In a battle zone, quick execution of these skills could mean the difference between life and death. Recruits will have to complete four crucial forms of rappelling: the seat hip rappel, the lizard rappel, the rundown rappel, and the heli rappel.
And then hawak sa brake. Get apart. Okay. Hold the rope.
Recruits 1 and 155 are up first, okay, with the seat hip rappel, used for mountain evacuations. Recruit 155 is one of the youngest in the course.
Nararamdaman ko po, kinakabahan po ako ngayon. And first time ko po ito nalulula dahil sa mataas ng
tatawin
nito.
Pagsubok
po sa buhay.
Okay, go. Ranger Robo, ready to perform! Seat hip rappel, start!
Go. Ranger Quirante, ready to perform!
The first exercise is cleared. They performed well, even recruit 155.
Ito lang yung nagawa namin na medyo kabado hanggang sa ngayon, kabado pa rin. Pagkatapos ko ng talon, parang nakangkit ko na yung kaba ko sa loob ko.
For the next few hours, each recruit gets a turn to perform the other three types of rappels.
Yung hindi namin napapansin na pag-aragala yung estudyante. Once na hindi ka hindi nakahukap, malaglag siya or matulak ng kasama.
For recruit 197, the lizard rappel, used for clearing rooms with hostages, is proving a challenge. This fully loaded M16 A1 rifle weighs over 3 kilograms.
Mas mahirap ito sa lizard, yung tali. Mas masakit siya sa biwang mo. Kasi pababa yung ulo, yung bigat na doon lahat, tapos may baril pa. Masakit talaga siya.
Next, they must conquer the slide for life, a 200-meter flying fox.
Ang importante po ng slide for life, kung nag-ooperate tayo, may mga cases na madana natin to, lalo na sa mga ilog, malalalim na ilog.
It's a 7-second expressway to safety or injury.
Kung pagdating mo doon sa taas, paghawak mo ng pulley, pag hindi ka nakagrip, may posibilidad na malalaglag ka dito. Tapos, makon yung katawan mo, ma-crack.
Not getting it right here won't kill them.
Na dapat doon sila bumagsak sa kabila dahil for secure. Kung dito kasi, delikado at medyo mababaw na sa ilir, may mga bato-bato na dyan.
But in the jungle, one mistake could mean death. Next up is amphibious training. Some recruits are weak swimmers. This phase will aim to weed out those that can't make the grade. Recruits will be thrown into this 12-foot deep river, blindfolded and in full combat gear, weighing 30 kilograms. The aim is to first disorient them, then see if they can calmly recover and reach the surface. For recruits terrified of water, this is their worst nightmare. Recruit 181 will confront one of his lifelong fears.
So, kinakabahan ako dito kasi dito, nahihina talaga ako sa kuwan, nanoy.
Nung nangyari sa akin noon, nalunog kasi ako, matagal akong sa yung sa tubig. May phobia na talaga ako dyan, pero sinusubukan ko lang yung parang kina-counter ko lang yung takot ko dyan.
Recruit 181 survives this first challenge. But up next is an even tougher one. In small groups, recruits must tread water for 30 minutes in this 5x5 meter square. Fresh water has a density lower than salt water, making floating much more difficult. For those waiting, the cold and cramping is causing problems they don't need.
1 minute. Ranger, ito kita. Ranger, kita.
Marunong lalumangoy, pero hindi ko sigurado kung tatagal ng 30 minutes sa tubig.
Madiki kayo dyan.
But recruits have more to worry about than staying afloat.
Prepare.
At the end of the 30 minutes, the instructors will jump in and attack the weak.
5 causes sakit na kayo. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Time!
If recruits don't have the energy or aggression to fight back, they could find themselves in deep trouble. If recruits fail the first time, they are forced to redo this until the course director is satisfied. For the poor swimmers, this is hell.
We have this drowning part for training for our recruits, for them to get prepared when they engage their enemies in the water, that someone is drowning them, they don't get panic, and they know what to do.
5 causes sakit na kayo. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Time!
Recruit 199 is in trouble.
Nang sinakyan na ako ni CD, talagang mabigat siya, parang mawawalan na ako ng malay talaga. Nauunti-unti na talagang maubos yung lakas.
The recruits survive amphibious training. But what lies ahead will test their nerves and risk their lives to become a Scout Ranger. The Scout Rangers are an elite strike unit on constant standby to deploy against insurgent groups across the Philippines archipelago. June 7th, 2001. Muslim insurgents, the Abu Sayyaf, hold 3 civilian hostages deep in the jungle after kidnapping them from the Dos Palmos Resort in Palawan a year before. After stalking them for days, Scout Rangers track the guerrillas' footprints through the night. By the next day, the Rangers creep within 30 meters of their targets. For the next 2 hours, they engage in intense firefight against 30 rebels in muddy and thick terrain. 4 enemies are left dead and 1 hostage rescued. Marksmanship is a key skill for a Ranger. Today, these recruits need to prove they have it.
Par when ready.
Fundamental understanding of positioning, aiming, breathing, and correct trigger pressing will be put to the test in 5 separate skills. Zeroing.
1 inch below the line of sight.
Endurance firing, record firing, and the sneaker course. But it is the final exam that is the most nerve-wracking of all. A confidence test that can kill. Recruits are required to shoot 2 bags full of colored water at a distance of 25 meters using this M16 A1 rifle with a 5.56 caliber round. First, they practice. Then their teammates hold the bags. At this range, a 5.56 round could kill. Hitting the thigh could rupture the femoral artery, one of the body's most important blood vessels. Rapid blood loss leading to death can occur in just 5 minutes, and the margin for error is slim.
So kahit na perfect na ibang part ng fundamentals, pag nagkaroon ng error sa trigger, konti lang, konting error lang, maaaring ang target hindi na siya tatamaan. Maaaring kakaliwa ang bala or kakanan.
This is more than just marksmanship. It's a test of trust.
Pagkaibigan mo kasi, kakabahan ka na maaari mo siyang matamaan o hindi.
It's judgment time. One target down. Lucky for his friend, Recruit 22 passed and they both move one step closer to being a ranger. Next, the recruits begin the Helleborn training phase. Scout rangers can deploy quickly into conflict areas by air. Landing into hostile territory, a helicopter is a big target. These men need to get out as quickly and safely as possible to avoid the helicopter getting hit.
Bali, ang tinuturo ko sa kanila ay paano yung tumalon and then i-secure yung mga landing zone, paano nila i-secure din yung mga personnel during movement, loading and unloading ng personnel.
Mistakes here can cost lives, even in training.
Napakahalaga yan na malaman nila kasi as a scout ranger, hindi mo na kailangan pang i-command.
First, recruits gear up for the quick deployment method. If the terrain is clear, the helicopter can fly fast and low while the troops disperse.
Makibagay ka, makisama, makiramdam mga dito sa surrounding.
It's a risky 10-foot jump, and one mistake could result in broken bones. Next, they have an even tougher challenge, heli-rappelling.
Yung heli-rappel ay ginagamit yan during infiltration, na kung saan hindi kayang bumaba ng aircraft, hindi kaya niyang bumaba ng sa ground, magtat sa ground, kaya kailangan magbaba yung tropa use of the rope.
Recruits practiced this skill at the tower earlier in training, but now they take it to new heights. They need to complete nerve-wracking drops from 50, 70, and finally 80 feet above the ground, with nothing to stop them but their hands.
Ang nervous ay hindi natin sa inevitable. Talagang ganyan. Pag una, nervous, pero i-control mo.
Recruits first tackle the 50-foot drop.
Tumalong ka ng isang bisis, paulit-ulit mo nang hanapin dahil nagaganahan ka na at excited ka na.
One step further at 70 feet, the winds become harder to battle.
The training is located near the mountainous area, so tendencies for the wind to blow from all directions, making it harder for the pilots to control the aircraft.
Next, it's time for the big one. One mistake during this 80-foot drop could prove fatal. Recruit 20 experiences trouble. He's unable to control his descent. Quickly, an instructor hits the brake.
Tuloy-tuloy na ako kaya kung halimbawa walang biliman tapos nangyari din sa team. Kung hindi ka naka-brake, diretso ka talaga. May tendency na mabalian ka or mamatay.
Tomorrow, the recruits will face their toughest challenge yet. 153 recruits remain in the fight to become an elite scout ranger. Today is the beginning of Hell Week. A culmination of everything they've learned put to the test.
For the next 6 days, there will be no rest for them. We push the students to the edge, testing their stamina, confidence, psychological toughness. As a day goes by, the test will get tougher.
If they fail one part, the recruits will be recycled to the next class or returned to their mother unit. First up is land navigation.
Land navigation is very important as a scout ranger. Scout rangers should never get lost in the jungle. If you get lost, you won't be able to accomplish your mission. You will jeopardize your team.
The stakes will be high in 3 months' time when these recruits face real enemies. They must prove they can lead the way. Each recruit is given a unique navigation route, comprising of any five of these 24 targets. The chart contains a set of colors with different corresponding letters. They have to find their way point to point, but no one route is the same for any of these 153 recruits. They have 4 hours to complete the test, and the course could see them covering over 12 kilometers. If a recruit returns late or does not complete his answer sheet correctly, he will fail. Recruit 8 has reached 3 of his 5 targets in under 2 hours.
It's 170 degrees and the distance is 1,100 meters from here. It's my 4th target.
Now onto his last destination.
Like I said, there's a stake under the mango trees.
But the directions to this one aren't as straightforward.
Ito, ito. Kung saan doon yung bakod na yan?
Yan pwede rin, sir.
Pag ganun? Diba ba?
He is lost.
Buhay ba kayo dito?
And he's not the only one. Time is ticking down. If they don't get back in the next hour, they will fail. And they're a long way from home. Recruits are battling to become elite Philippine Scout Rangers. It's Hell Week. And they're in the middle of their navigation exam. Time is running out for Recruit 8, while some have already made it to the finish line. But the mistakes are numerous.
Siguro hindi nila na kukuha yung basic ba na dapat gawin. Kung paano kumuha ng reference, kung paano mag-plot ng kumpas sa mapa.
One has run into bad luck. Recruit 205 claims he has been the victim of theft. A cow has eaten his test paper.
Rice!
The instructors don't believe him. It's a nervous wait as they check out his story.
Sinasabi ko naman ang totoo. So, sa instructor na lang yan kung maniwala sa hindi, basta...
They can't verify his story, but they will give him the benefit of the doubt. Recruit 205 is given another chance at the test.
Banat, he will join.
But fail this time, and he will be out of the course. Back in the field, Recruit 8 gets some help.
Sir? Pero doon sila, dinaanan yun. Saan? Sino po siya? Sa, ano,
With just 50 minutes to go, his fifth and final station is done. Recruit 8 heads back to the training school to meet his comrades. Recruit 205 returns from his second consecutive test, just in the nick of time. It's the moment of truth. But it's not good news.
Sa pag-umpisa pa lang, wala na. Pangalawa, wala din.
Ano, Chris? Zero?
Wala, sir. Wala talaga. Hindi talaga tumama.
He's failed. As a recycled recruit, it is certain that his journey to be a scout ranger is over.
Tatlo pa once na kamali ka sa unang target pa lang, kamali na talaga natin. Kaya doon ako talaga ba? Doon ako talaga sumablay.
At the end of the navigation day, 20 recruits have failed. For recruit 35, it's a cruel end of the road.
Talagang masakit talaga. Hindi ko akalain na sa tagal ng ano, sa tagal namin na training, tapos yung pinag-iingat-ingata mo na training mo, eh, para isang pagkakamali mo lang, biglang nawala lahat, nag-uunaw lahat.
But the night is not over for those who remain. The recruits are not allowed to rest. They're kept up all night practicing martial arts. This is not designed to make them experts at fist fighting, but to wear them down. 7 a.m., another grueling day of testing begins. It's the water confidence exam. Recruits will complete the aptly named slide for life. But first, they need to successfully swim across this lake in uniform and combat boots, weighing down the body. Recruit 181 struggled with the earlier swimming tests. But this one is harder. The weaker swimmers panic.
Nasa gitna ako ng tubig, halos marami akong nainom na tubig na pumasok sa bunganga ko. Talagang pilit ko pa rin nilulutang yung sarili ko sa taas para makakuha ng hangin. Akala ko hindi ko may susurvive yung langoy.
It's recruit 181's turn. Fail this and he will be off the course. Despite teammates and instructors' support, it's not his day. Recruit 181 will be recycled with 16 others who have failed the swim.
Jan, alam ko talaga na hindi talaga ko papasa dyan. Wala na talagang lakas kasi sinabi ko na ilang araw na kami walang tulog. Pero before mag-open yung next class, practice muna ako ng langoy.
But his fellow failed comrades don't take the news so well.
Ready, ready. Bakit nangyayang ka? So, itong class na to, kasi maski anong pilitin natin, hindi man rin kayo pala makakapasa. Next class kayo mag-join. Kuha?
Yes, sir.
So, magbalot ng mga gamit nyo.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yan lang.
Day 4 of Hell Week. 116 recruits remain in the Philippines Scout Ranger training course. Over 40% of the class have dropped out or failed in the last 2 months.
Pagod po yan. Parang yung katawan mo yung ibigay. Kailangan mo yung palakasin mo yung isip mo, stamina para makasurvive.
And with 2 more days of Hell Week, followed by a real operation against real insurgents, the road ahead is long.
Miss ko yung mag-ina ko. Mag-ina ko, anak ko. Hope. Sana na maintindihan nila ang trabaho ko. Malakas pa rin ako. Kaya ko to i-survive.
4 a.m., recruits have to complete a 24-kilometer rucksack march. They haven't slept in over 100 hours.
Medyo pagod pa ang katawan, pero kakayanin. Para sa mga mahal sa buhay, Isipin na lang na madali na makita yung kwan.
Even worse, they will have to carry 35 kilograms of gear on their backs. They march as a team, but it's an individual assessment. For Recruit 8, it's as much a mental battle as physical pain.
Sige, kailangan matapos to. Hindi. Babagsak. Sayang naman mga pinakirapan namin sa dalawang buwan.
There's less than 2 hours left, but the strain of 35 kilograms is showing.
Okay, nagbaba na kayo kasi nang raksak.
Buwabaon na itong jungle pack namin sa dito namin. Sakit na rin sa baan. Pero malayo pa ang nakakari namin.
The march comes to a halt. But these exhausted recruits don't know what's coming next. It has all been a ruse. For the most feared test yet, escape and evasion is about to start.
Escape and evasion is an exercise wherein students get a chance to feel what it's like being caught by the enemy.
Recruits will be held captive and treated as prisoners of war. It's a reality that could happen in just 3 months when they go into real battle. Robbed of their vision, their binds are positioned to maximize pain.
Mandir, pag mo na lahat,
yung kali sa
kontrol. We don't do this to traumatize our recruits. We do this to remind them never get caught by the enemy, because the enemy will show no mercy on them, and eventually they'll be killed.
Scout Ranger recruits have endured 9 weeks of physical hell, but nothing could have prepared them for this, escape and evasion. For the next 17 hours, recruits will be subjected to various forms of torture. The aim is to make them fear capture.
Experience ko naman sa Eko-Eko ay biglaan, nakakagulat na di mo talaga maasahan na mangyari habang nakadapa kami dun. So parang nararamdaman ko na yung mangyayari sa katawan ko. Parang alam ko na dito talaga mahihirapan ako.
Mamatay ka na lang kaysa mahulik ka pa. Pero talaga, sumasagi sa utak o isip mo na kailangan ko talagang tumakbo. Wala na yata, parang papatay na kayo eh. Pero pag doon pa lang nararanasan mo ng sakit, hindi ka na makapag-isip. Hindi ka makasurvive doon.
For Recruit 2, it's a brutal lesson in survival.
I think your loyalty to your country is really being tested. You will realize, or you will give information to the enemy once you experience pain.
It's been 12 hours since the recruits were captured. What happens during this time is top secret.
Really one of the worst experiences, if not the worst experience of my life.
Recruits have been through 4 months of punishing training, but it's not over yet. Recruits 2 and 3 are longtime friends. They've had the rare experience of going through all their military training together.
The pressure here is very heavy. We come from different units, so from the start, we found it very hard to adjust.
Your patience is being tested until you explode, you know, until you cannot carry yourself anymore. As classmates, we really do our best in order to help each other to maintain our strength and to graduate eventually someday.
For the months to come, I think that my dependency on him will continue. I rely on him very much, and if ever he will not be around, it would really affect me personally.
Tonight, these two will lead the final platoon run, a test of teamwork and stamina. Next time they carry these 18-kilogram packs, it will be for their final test mission, a real battle. But some have additional burdens, like this MG-60 machine gun.
Lang ko lang 20 kilos yung dala ko.
Makabot po doon ng 7 kilo po ito.
They have just 2.5 hours to complete a 17-kilometer circuit in the dark.
So, ang reason na bakit kinakandak ang platoon run sa gabi, yung kagamitan ng ano na hindi kaya pasukin ng mga military vehicle, yung mga area, so kailangan na double time.
Split into 4 platoons, they will be staggered at 10-minute intervals, one after another. As a team assessment, they must leave no one behind. If they do, every member of the platoon might fail the course.
So, mapaback down pa lang siya, tutulungan na. Hindi yung, kung saan siya back down, doon na siya i-assist.
They draw grass to see which platoon will go first. And they're off. Hey, 60 minutes into the run, so far, so good. The first platoon arrives at the turning point, but some begin to slow down. The platoons only have 30 minutes left to hit the finish line. Team spirit is vital in completing the run, and Recruit 3 has taken on additional weight.
Yung iba sa amin, pagod na yung mga kamay. Kaya pinapabuhat nila yung mga recruit sa iba. Talitan lang, swapping. Mapapansin nyo, pinapauna namin yung mga mahihina. Eh kung hindi namin paunahin yung mga mahihina, hindi sila makakahabol pag nahuli sila. So kailangan mauna sila.
It in time.
We feel happy because we did it properly and we get a time we pass.
It's a defining moment for Recruit 3.
For me as the platoon leader of 2nd Platoon, I think it's one of the most fulfilling event in my entire training. And this is also a test for our platoon mates, for the integrity of our platoon. And as you can see, some of us were shouting because this is the last night that we will be carrying those heavy loads.
It's a moment to celebrate, but not for long. They need to prove they have the combat skills to match. Soon, the recruits will face the ultimate challenge, a real test mission. Real enemies, real conflict. One they might not return from.
Test mission is a must for the members in order for them to graduate. That differentiates the Ranger training from all other military training.
They could face the Abu Sayyaf, the Moro Islamic Liberation Front, and the New People's Army. Battle-hardened insurgents. But Recruit 3 is not daunted.
Every mission given to us, we will accomplish them with a great achievement. And here in Scout Ranger Training School, they're not just training soldiers to become rangers, but rangers to become heroes.
As Recruit 3 and his class head into real battle to gain membership into this elite club, the class ahead has just returned from their test mission.
I have the honor to present to you two Army officers. 85 Army enlisted personnel. And two police non-commissioned officers who have satisfactorily completed all the requirements of Scout Ranger course.
These 89 recruits have endured one of the longest test missions in training history.
We spent 2 months in the Eastern Mindanao Command. Five personnel, Army personnel, have abducted and we are tasked to rescue them.
But one recruit didn't make it back.
Accept also the soul of the class member who offered the ultimate sacrifice for peace.
Sobrang lungkot, tapos yung tao pa na halos nagsasabi ng problema, tapos yung taong pwede mo rin masabihan ng problema. Basta masakit din sa akin kasi halos naging parang kapatid ko na rin siya.
One man died trying to earn this badge. But for those in this class that survived,
by virtue of the authority vested in me as the commander of 1st Scout Ranger Regiment,
these 8 months of hardship have earned them the tabak tab.
2013, I hereby declare the students of Scout Ranger course graduates effective today. Congratulations.
After being tested under fire, they now have the right to call themselves Scout Rangers.
We are happy and free. Birds of some feather, we gather together. Scout Rangers of fortune are we. We sing greetings the night with a song. Laughing at danger, we fight like a panther and conquer. I'm not going to do that.